Harold Henry Hill Simpson, born in Bayview, Prince Edward Island, on March 17, 1897. Simpson, aged 18, enlisted in Charlottetown in the Canadian Expeditionary Forces in September of 1915. And following two horrendous years of trench warfare on the Western Front, Harold wrote a touching and poignant letter to his mother on Christmas Day, 1915. It gives us a vivid picture of life on the front line at that time.
On Christmas Day, on the Western Front, the guns all died away, and lying in the mud on bags of sand, we heard a German sing from no man's land. He had a tenor voice so pure and true. The words were strange, but every note we knew. Soaring o'er the living, dead and damned, the German sang of peace from no man's land.
December 25th, 1917. France. Dear Mother. Well, from the 21st until Christmas, we spent all our spare time getting the dugout fixed up as nicely as possible. And by Christmas Day, we had it nicely decorated. Yesterday, Albert, Dennis, and I went out and gathered some green branches, spruce, fir, and cedar. Also, the leaves of some evergreen shrub, which I did not recognize, but which were very pretty, and we easily decorated our home. Not having quite enough material, we went out again. And this time, we found a real holly tree. And with it, we were well away. We decorated our mirror with the leaves of the evergreen shrubs, the posts of our supports with cedar and fir, and the supports themselves with holly. By the time we had finished, our home looked more like some farmer's paradise than a bare French cellar a mile and a half away from the German. After dinner, we sat around the fire and talked. Talked of the old days back home before the war. Talked of our training days and talked of the life out here. Of our last Christmas also spent on the line. And of the events of the intervening year. Presently, someone suggested the question, where will we spend next Christmas? And in answer to it, some of the more optimistic among us said, Canada. A couple of pessimists among us suggested that probably we would still be in France.
They left their trenches and we left ours. Beneath tin hats, smiles bloomed like wildflowers. With photos, cigarettes, and pots of wine, we built a soldier's truce on the front line. Their singer was a lad of 21. We begged another song before the dawn. And sitting in the mud and blood and fear, he sang again the song all longed to hear. Cannons roar. A king is born of peace forevermore. All's calm, all's bright, all brothers hand in hand. In 19 and 15 in no man's land.
So the day passed, and now it is Christmas night. How I would like to be with you all tonight. I wonder what kind of night it is at home. We had a light flurry of snow just at dark, and now the moon is shining bright and clear upon it from a cloudless sky. Everything is perfectly quiet. It is as though the two opposing forces had agreed to make this day as peaceful as possible. And except for the occasional report of a gun, one would never know that there's a war on.
And in the morning, all the guns boomed in the rain. And we killed them, and they killed us again. At night, they charged, we fought them hand to hand. And I killed the boy that sang in no man's land.
There is just one thing that I would like this evening. As I looked out over the peaceful scene tonight with the glittering white snow sparkling under the moonbeams, I could not help thinking what a perfect ending a nice sleigh drive would make to this Christmas. With a heart full of love to all, from your soldier son, Harold.
Stille Nacht, no cannons roar. A king is born of peace forevermore. Soldier sings, and the song of peace still rings, though the captains and all